Oh my God, I'm nervous. This is gonna happen in front of everyone. She's shocked.
Hey guys, how's it going? Today we're filming episode 5 of The Sims 4 Tiny Living Rags to Riches Challenge that I have on my channel. If you guys have not seen any of the episodes from this series, I will link them up here or down below so you can check those out before watching this video. In the last episode, Olive was entering a new chapter of her life. We just bought a new store. We've learned a lot about our relationships and our friendships, so we're gonna see how those progress in this episode. And we are definitely going to do some renovations to our tiny house. We didn't get to that in the last episode because we spent all our money on our new store. But yeah, we're about to see how this new chapter unfolds for Olive. Let's get into the episode.
Okay, so we left off here. It's Winterfest and Santa Claus is just making himself comfortable. We're just trying to watch some TV, but here he is. I actually just finished giving Alice a little makeover. I'll show you guys really quick. I think she looks so cute. She was already really adorable before, but I just quickly changed her outfit. A lot of her outfits that she came with were yellow, so I pretty much tried to stick with that theme. Yeah, I don't know. I think she's a really cute Sim. And then I also got to see her treats, and she and Olive are so similar. So I'm pretty happy with the friendship that's blossoming here. They have gotten along so well, and yeah, I don't know. I think this is a really good thing that she has Alice in this time of hardship that she's kind of going through. In the last episode, Olive celebrated her birthday and she went out and had some drinks, went to the bar. And of course, we invited our girlfriend Angela and our friends Brant and Lilith, and none of them showed up. So it's been a couple of days now and we still haven't talked to them. So I think in this episode, I'm gonna try and either resolve those issues that she's having or completely cut them off. Olive is a Sim who ran away from home. That's how she ended up here. So she's kind of used to running away from her problems. So I can kind of see her running away from this situation, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. You can see our money is at zero. That's because we bought a store. It was like $70,000. It was so expensive, but I'm hoping that this will help us bring in the money a little bit faster so we can get going on editing our little house. I am going to do a little bit of renovations at the store as well, I think, but my main goal is to do renovations on the house because we didn't do that in the last episode. So for now, I think we're going to say goodbye to Santa and go to bed, and then we can get some work done. Oh, we also have a little cow plant back here, and the cake is out. So put that away, sir. Just please put that away. Don't kill Santa. He's just like making himself comfortable. Like, you're not even, I know I don't have a tree or anything, but it looks like we have a few things to harvest over here. Oh no, our cow plant died. No, our cow plant died already. Shit! We do have a perk that our plants grow like extremely fast because of the tiny house that we have, but I think this is almost a bad thing because our plants die also like really quickly, so we have to stay on top of it. And when we have so many other things to be doing, it's kind of annoying. Oh, we fell! I've never seen that happen. Oh, that sucked. Good thing no one was here to see that. I'm gonna get her to take a quick shower. Then I'm gonna head over to the store. And I keep wanting to call it a restaurant, but we're gonna go over to the store, check it all out because we haven't set anything up over there yet. And I really wanna get that up and running. I'm gonna maybe see if I can bring Alice because I'm gonna want a second opinion. In this situation, I feel like it would be nice to have a second opinion when you're making big decisions and stuff like this. And Alice has been there for us, so we're gonna invite her along with us. So for the most part, I think the store is pretty cute. Inside, the things are a little strange. I eventually want to put some of her paintings up here. So I think this is probably gonna be the first area that we reno, but we're not gonna do it yet. Before anything, I wanna get some money coming in like ASAP. So it's been a while since I've managed a store in The Sims, but I'm gonna try my best. I know we're gonna need employees. We're gonna need some advertising. First thing I want to do, I'm going to set everything up here for sale. Another thing that I do want to try and do, someone mentioned this in the comments, and I'm so thankful for you guys leaving tips for me because sometimes I forget all of these little like things that you can do in the game. You can get the rewards traits, and this one in here will sell items that your Sims have crafted for more simoleons. So I need to get this trait for sure because that'll help us a lot. We haven't really been working on this at all, but I think I need to start working on that so that I can get more points, so that I can get that reward trait, because I think that would really help us out and be really beneficial on top of the traits that we're already using to our benefit. I think I've gotten everything in here for the most part so far. I think I'm gonna come up here and delete this stuff, and I'm gonna put an easel up here so that we can maybe like start off right away painting, like if we're bored, if we're like not making many sales or something. I don't know how busy it's gonna be in here. I might be shooting myself in the foot, but we'll see. I should have just brought the one from home because I don't want to have to buy another one. Or should I have both because I can paint in both spots? Okay, you know what? I'm going to put this in here. It's just going to be one easel. There we go. We're going to make our money back pretty quickly from that, I think. Okay, should I open the store? I'm nervous. Let's open the store day one. We'll see how it goes and we'll see if we're going to end up needing employees. I'm pretty sure I'm shooting myself in the foot. Okay, it's open. Okay. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I wasn't sure if this was going to be the right idea for me to buy the store, but like I'm really, really excited about this. So the store is open and customers are on their way to peruse Olive's merchandise. Any hired employees will be arriving momentarily. Be sure to assign them to a task to perform during their shift. I didn't do that yet. I want to see how it goes first. I don't want to have to waste money. Oh my gosh. Olive is like, I'm so happy I'm here for this grand opening with you. Thank you for inviting me. Yeah, I'm in this with you. We're going to do this together. Even though she has nothing to do with the store really, but oh, wait a minute. Over here, this is interesting. Here's Lilith. Lilith is casually walking by the store. And I wonder if she's heard through the grapevine that we've purchased the store and she's coming by to like check it out or like spy on us or something. I kind of want to approach her. I think I'm going to approach her and just be like, where were you? For some reason, it's not really even letting me interact with her. Probably because she's giving us the cold shoulder. Oh no, here we go. Oh, this is awkward. This is the first interaction that they've had since Lilith like ditched us and left us stranded and drunk alone on our birthday. Lilith is also like not the easiest sim to get along with. So I'm pretty sure she's like mocking us and just like completely like not listening to what we're having to say. I feel like she would be pretty immature about the situation. Yeah, she's just arguing back with us and this is really getting nowhere. So you know what? We're just gonna leave. We've heard what we needed from her and clearly we don't need that in our life right now. But in the meantime, the store is bumping. Oh my God, get back in here. Oh shit. I definitely made the wrong decision by not hiring employees. Alice, get to work. Okay, get back in here. What do we do? What do we do? Greet customer. Oh yeah, we have to greet customers. Greet all the customers. Can we hire Alice? Can she work with us? I kind of want her to be like working alongside us. From what I remember, I'm pretty sure if a customer wants to buy, they have a little thing like up above them. Oh, a loiterer. Get out of here. So there's loiterers and there's customers. Discuss shopping preferences. Answer questions. Oh God. I know there are traits that you can get for this as well so that your business like does better. Alice is a natural over here. She's over here like, oh, what can I get for you, ladies and man? Oh, this guy's like close. This guy's close to buying, I think. Look at all these people. All right, you. I want you, Gunner, to buy my stuff. What a choice. I'm ready to buy. Who? You? Okay, okay, okay. I'm coming. I'm coming. Aliyah Gills. Oh, she's like, hello, I'm over here. I want to buy this purple thing. Ring up, customer. Go, go, go. Ring her up. Oh my God, how much are we gonna get? What a choice. Oh my God, someone else. Woo! Oh shoot, I feel like this is gonna take forever. Oh my God, there's more. Yes. Uh-oh, she's getting uncomfortable. Don't get uncomfortable. We have to ring through our customers. Okay, we're doing good so far. We're doing good. $412. Slow and steady. We're getting there though. I know there are like more expensive things that you can buy. Like a lot of these things in here, I feel like don't sell for that much. So maybe once they do sell, I'll replace them with more expensive things like as we get more money. Oh, this is fun. I'm really enjoying this for sure. I'm pretty much going to stay open, I think, until she gets too uncomfortable to do anything. And then we'll shut her down and hire some employees, I think. Angela's calling us. Our store is bumping right now and she's calling to hang out with us. No, Angela, I'm busy living my life, making that money. I'll talk to you tomorrow. She developed a quirk. So because of her fame from her like painting that she's been doing, everyone seems to think that she's all right with having her personal space invaded. She'll now become tense when Sims who aren't her family members or those that she isn't in a committed relationship with make physical contact with her. Well, that's gonna be hard when you're surrounded by people all day. Oh, but this girl just made a huge purchase. What did she buy? Oh, she bought one of the boats. Those we'll have to keep in stock because those are making a lot of money. It's getting hard for me to keep up with ringing in everyone's thing. So I'm gonna have to shut it down. It's 1 a.m. After these orders, I think I'm going to have to call it a night because she's about to fall asleep. She's worked so hard, but we've made good money today. Oh no, these ones are gonna be lost. Hurry up. Oh no, we lost one. Damn it. Yeah, we're gonna definitely have to hire some people to help out here. So I'm gonna ring this last one through and we're gonna have to shut it down. Oh shoot, we just lost one guy. Oh, whatever. But day one went pretty well. We made $7,689. So that's not bad. We are gonna close up. Unfortunately, that guy was ready to buy and now he can't. But we, I think, are gonna go home because that was a busy day. We're exhausted and we're gonna come back bright and early and keep it going. How many points did we get? We did get 330 points from our first day. So I want to use some of these points for sure. I just don't know how I'm gonna use them yet. Okay, I don't want her to sleep in too much because I want to open the store and there's things I want to get done today. So we're gonna harvest all of this stuff. We're gonna use the washroom, then we're gonna head back to the store and I think I'm going to get her to start painting. We have to replenish the inventory. Maybe we won't actually open the store today. We'll just do some work and then open it back up again tomorrow because it's already 2 o'clock. I do want her to see Angela at some point today too. Okay, so we sold a lot of our inventory. We're gonna have to replace a lot of that stuff. I'm gonna take a look at some of these perks because if I can avoid hiring people, I want to do that. So a lot of this stuff is really expensive to restock. Like this over here is like $1,000. So I think I'm going to get her to go upstairs and start painting her little butt off. So we're gonna start painting like crazy and put some of those in this room for sale. This is gonna be a painting day for her. We need this stock to get together here. Actually, Angela's calling. Hey, Olive, it's me, Angela. Do you want to go out on a date? Her fun is at zero. I can have her come back and paint through the night, I think. So we're gonna go actually and pay Angela a little visit because we still have not talked to her about the fact that she ditched us. So we're gonna try that out and see what happens with her. I think we're gonna approach this in a way that, because like I said, Olive normally runs away from her problems, I feel like she wouldn't be very good at communicating. So she's kind of giving her the cold shoulder. She's like, you know what you did. That made the relationship go down a little bit. They're like arguing quite a bit. She's saying, you completely left me, hung me out to dry. You didn't call me for days. I'm just confused. I thought things were going well and you guys all just ditched me. And she's kind of thinking too that maybe Angela was like not happy about where she came from because this all happened right after Angela saw our house and we were nervous about that. Things are escalating like pretty quickly. Like Olive is not taking it. Oh, and yeah, see, it's about money. It's about money. I knew it. I knew it. No, that's it. Olive is not gonna take this. She works way too hard. She's worked her ass off to have everything that she has. So you know what? No, we're gonna break up with you, Angela. I don't think it's gonna work. I don't think it's gonna work. You don't understand where we come from and the hard work that we've done? No. Oh, she's running away. Where is she going? She won't let us break up with her. Where are you going? She's gone in here. She's like, well, catch me if you can. She's just gone and started talking to this guy? Absolutely not. No. Oh, imperfect. Brant is here, so he can watch this go down. Perfect. And while I have you both listening, I don't think I'm gonna be talking to you either, Brant. Oh my God, I'm nervous. This is gonna happen in front of everyone. Yo, old man, that was my seat. This is so awkward. Brant pretty much just walked literally straight through us, didn't even mention anything, and walked out the door. These friends, I don't understand. She's breaking up with her from across the room. Oh my God. She's shocked. Look how sassy she is. She's like, see ya, we're through. Oh my God, Angela did not take that well at all. But now she's like back in her composure. She's like, I'm fine. I'm fine. Everything's fine. Ugh, I don't like her very much. All right, Olive, I think we got to get out of here. This is awkward now. I think we need to go back to the store, maybe. This date is clearly over. Well, I guess this is goodbye. Don't call me ever. All right, we won't. I'm gonna send her back over to the store. and invite Alice to come by. We really just need someone to talk to at this point. We need a friend's shoulder to cry on, and we know that Alice will be that person for us. So before she starts painting or doing anything, we're just going to tell her really quickly what happened. And Alice is like, you know what? Screw her. That night, you were so upset when she ditched you, and they just became good friends because of it. I love Alice. I think she's such a sweetheart. Alice has brought over some food for us. She's preparing a salad right in the middle of the store. What a freaking sweetheart. So that's perfect because we're hungry. Hopefully she's prepared enough for all of us. Oh, she just made herself a salad. Okay, you know what? We'll let that one slide. Okay, I can go upstairs. We've got a vending machine. So yeah, we're gonna continue on our painting. We need to get our stock going here. So I'm gonna let her paint for as long as I possibly can. She painted a masterpiece. Perfect. Honestly, when Olive is upset about something, she will always paint a masterpiece. Okay, great. So that can go up. We'll set that for sale. Hopefully we can get a lot of money from that. All right, keep going. I remember in the first episode, it was a goal of hers to have a gallery when we were going through the dumpsters. So I'm really excited for this room to be finished because I feel like it's going to be a really nice full circle moment. She's actually painting them out really quickly too, which is nice. Another masterpiece. Good girl. Okay, she's officially too uncomfortable to finish painting, so I'm going to get her needs taken care of quickly, and shit, I'm gonna bring her back pretty early. It's gonna be a rough day tomorrow. Okay, time to go back. Time to open the store for the second official day, and I think I am going to hire someone. I'm gonna hire someone just so they can do, like, the talking, I think. Okay, select a sim to hire. Giselle Emery. Skylar Broomberg. Okay, so wait. They're handy. Their sales aren't that good. This guy's sales are really good. I think I'm going to hire her because her sales are good. There we go. We have an employee. Luna Villarreal. Okay, cool. So let's open the store. Do I want to purchase advertising? Let's just see how it goes. No, we'll wait. We'll wait. Let's open the store. We'll wait until we have a little more money. Okay, day two. I'm nervous. Oh my god, I thought she just like died out here or something. My angel. She's so cute. Okay, so this is Luna. This is our employee. Look at her go. Look at that strut coming in for work. Okay, girl. That's not how I personally walk into work, but she's ready. So there we are. And she's going straight to talk to Alice. Okay, hi. We're gonna have to go and check up on you. Angela's calling and she said, hey, I heard you and Alice are good friends now. You're getting more popular. Clearly you're a good person to know. No, I don't like you. I don't like that you're calling because I'm getting more famous. I don't like anything about that. Leave me alone, Angela. Okay, so we're checking up on her and she says, things are okay. You could always pay me more and see if I improve. Actually, no, you're still out here just talking to... And she sits back down and she starts talking to Alice. Girl, get your ass up and get to work. I'm going to assign her a task. She's going to answer customers' questions. That's what I want you to do. That's what I hired you for. I don't want to have to talk to people all day. Where are people getting all these drinks? Is it because it's New Year's Eve? People are just kind of like, okay, we can drink on the job. Like Luna. It really looks like Luna's just like invited her friends up in here and like they're all just kind of drinking now. Oh, I think Alice left us a salad. I saw her like earlier making another one. We have someone buying a painting. Ring him up before he pees. He has to go to the bathroom. Oh my god, go, 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 go. Oh my god, could she get there any slower? Okay, there we go. Yay, he's buying the pop art painting. Nice. We've sold our first painting. I'm so excited. Today so far has been worse than the first day. We haven't really made much money at all. Angela is calling us and saying it's singles night at the bar. Let's go out and meet someone new. Hard pass. I can think of a million things I'd rather be doing. Oh god, there's so many. And she has to pee. I don't think I'm gonna have time to ring everyone up. Go! Oh my god, I'm stressed. We're losing customers. Oh, and she wants to buy another painting. Oh my gosh, hurry up. Why? No. Oh my god, they're coming in really quickly now. She's buying another painting. No, she fell asleep before she could ring up a customer. Get up. Luna has been so unhelpful today. Oh, I'm definitely not gonna keep her on, I don't think. Okay, we're gonna have to close it up. Close the store. Ugh. So we made $3,000 today. We had to pay Luna $248. She honestly, I don't think deserved that. She didn't do anything. So we're gonna manage employees before we leave here. Yeah, she's fired. I feel like I could do what she did by myself, especially since the first day we made more money. I need more paintings too. Like, our stock is running a little low. I think I've decided what I want to do is get rid of everything in the store at the bottom part, and then we'll replace everything with paintings because I don't want to have to restock all that stuff. Oh my God, she's so tired. She didn't even make it in the door. Okay, so it's also springtime now, which means all of these plants are ready for us. So hopefully that'll be another big income coming in. Okay, so we made $10,000 since the store opened. So I'm going to take some of that and put that into our little house because I didn't do any renovations in the last episode. This is pretty much as big as we can make it. We have placed 30 tiles out of 32, and we need to keep it under 32 to keep the micro build. I think the biggest thing I have to renovate is the living room, so I'm going to do a full reno on that, I think. I think I'm going to move everything outside for right now just so I can see what I'm working with again. The door is red, so I think I want to actually change the color scheme for everything, and I'm going to change the layout too. I think I'm going to have to play around with a couple of options before I come to a decision, but I think I want to put the kitchen here and then maybe the living room more over on that side. Then we can put a full sink in here and have a little like area over there for preparing food. I've switched out some counters. I'm gonna put some curtains up too because this is Strangerville and people tend to come and go a lot here. Not really seeing any that I like here though. I just kind of wanted to give her a little bit of privacy. I mean, we've come a long way from having our bathroom like outside, so she might be used to it at this point. Maybe I'll just give her something like that for now. Okay, so I've put up this little picture here. I've changed the curtains to blue and I changed the door color because I think it looks better with the inside. I'm not entirely sold on it yet, but we'll see. I'm liking that little color scheme that's happening right now. So I'm going to try and go with that. I'm going to maybe put up a little carpet at the entrance, kind of just something small for when you like walk in. Maybe something like that, and then it kind of pulls it together as well. I'm not sure if that like conflicts with the shapes here though. Maybe that's better. Okay, I'm gonna do that one instead because I don't want it to be too much distracting from that. Okay, so then we have the fridge here. I guess I could actually do another cabinet over there maybe, or maybe I could do an oven right there, and then we have a fully functioning kitchen. I think I want to get a new fridge too. We have quite a bit of money to use, so I think I'm going to go all out on at least this room here. She deserves it. Okay, so now we have fully functioning sink, counter space, stove, and fridge. I'm excited about this. Ooh, okay. Now somehow I'm gonna have to squeeze in a couch and the TV back over there. So maybe we'll put the TV back up here and then I'll get a couch going in here. I'm gonna get her a nicer couch than we had before, but I need to make sure that it fits properly. The hard part about this is that it's hard to visualize because the room is so small. I can't put like all the walls up and like really see properly the whole picture. I'm trying to use this rug to like pull the room together kind of, but it's really not working for me. I don't know if it's like the rug that I don't like or the positioning. I'll put that one aside. We might use that one, or that one kind of works too, and then it keeps with like the triangle theme. Maybe I'll go with that. It's just kind of awkward because like the TV is not in the center. I'm having such a hard time with this. I can't tell if I like what's happening here or not. I don't know. Okay. So I've spent about $5,000. I've done quite a bit of renos, but I don't know how I'm totally feeling about the decorations yet. We have a fully functioning kitchen. We have a fully functioning living room. The bathroom obviously is still the same. I haven't done any work on that yet. I've added in this little table with a plant here, a little lamp, and cute little sitting area with the rug. We have the stove and the fridge. Over here, we've got the sink and a little area to prep the food. I've given her new sheets, new pillows, and some blinds, and just some lighting for the bedroom here. I also just did some renos for the bathroom. It's really hard for me to show you guys because it's so little, but I put up some curtains. We've got a little mirror, shower, sink, fully functioning everything. So yeah, our tiny house is looking good so far. I think eventually if I want to add more stuff, I would add like another floor maybe. And then we can keep expanding because I do want to spend a lot more money on this place. But I just spent $7,000 with all the renovations that we did now, and that leaves us enough money to do some renos on the store, and it'll allow us to restock and keep painting. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end it here. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Things are changing for Olive. This is a new chapter, and I'm excited for it. We're just gonna have to wait and see what happens in the next episode.
Alright guys, so that's it for today's video. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and leave any comments or suggestions you may have in the comment section down below. If you guys are looking for more series to watch, I will link those playlists down below so you can binge those as well. And don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!